Today we will see the working of a linear variable differentiation transducer, or it is called a LVDT. So it is a transducer which works on the principle of mutual inductance. So we have an LVDT. So it is working under the principle of mutual induction and displacement, which is non-electrical energy is converted into an electrical energy. So what is mutual inductance? So whenever the property of a coil due to which it opposes the change in current in the other coil, or you can say the neighboring coil. So whenever the current in the neighboring coil is changing, there will be a flux set up in the coil, and because of this changing flux, there will be EMF induced in the neighboring coil, and that phenomenon is called mutual inductance. So that is actually made use in this LVDT transducer. So in order to clear the construction of LVDT transducer, we will see the figure. So figure shows an LVDT transducer. So there we have a primary winding and two secondary windings. So primary winding is represented as coil A, and we have secondary coils B and C, and also a movable core is placed in the air gap between the primary and secondary coil. This movable core is connected to the point where we have to measure the displacement. So the principle is like this: whenever we apply an AC voltage across the primary winding, as you can see, V1 voltage is applied across the coil A, which is a primary winding. There will be a change in flux in the air gap due to alternating current. That change in flux induces an EMF in both the secondary coils B and C. So that is what is called mutual inductance. So that is the principle which is used in this LVDT. So the output of the voltage from which is coming out from coil B and C is represented as V2, which gives a measure of the displacement happened to the point under reference. So that is how this LVDT transducer construction. So when we move to the working, so we can see we can split the working into three cases based on the position of this movable core in the air gap. So first case is, on applying an external force which is displacement, the core remains in null position itself without providing any movement. Then the voltage is induced in both the secondary windings are equal, which result in net output equal to zero. That is, when there is no displacement to the reference point, the movable core will remain in null position. That is, it is not moving. So that means there is no displacement happened to the point under reference. So there will be equal induced EMF in coil B and C. So the change in EMF, which is V2, or difference in EMF between coil B and C, will be zero. That is what is represented here. That is EMF in secondary 1 minus EMF in secondary 2. That is, secondary 1 is secondary coil 1, that is B, and secondary 2 is secondary coil 2, that is C. So since both the coils have same EMF or voltage induced, the difference is zero. That means there is no output voltage V2. Then coming to the case 2, that is when the core is moving upward, this movable core is moving towards the upper side, or displacement is happening such a way that the core is moving upwards. So in that case, we can see when an external force is applied, that is case 2, when an external force is applied, and if the steel iron or core tends to move in the upper side direction, then the EMF voltage induced in the secondary coil B is greater than when compared to the EMF induced in the secondary coil C. That is, when the core is moving towards upper side, we can see that there will be more EMF induced in coil B compared to mutually induced EMF in coil C. So difference between B and C is shown here. That is, therefore, the net output will be EMF in secondary B minus EMF in secondary C. That will become a positive value because EMF induced in the secondary coil is higher than that of EMF induced in the secondary coil C. Sorry, EMF induced in the secondary coil B is higher than that of EMF induced in the secondary coil C, since the core is moving upwards. So we'll get a positive value. So you can take an example to clear that. So let us see the EMF voltage on secondary coil B is 3 volt and EMF voltage on the secondary coil C is 2 volt. Then net EMF is, that is 3 minus 2, that is 1 volt. You get a positive value. So that is, the output V2 will be 1 volt. That is the case when the core is moving upwards. So that is shown here in the form of a graph. So we can see the E-in, that is input EMF or input voltage, that is having a higher magnitude or higher amplitude. The E-out is having a lower amplitude. That is E-in is having 3 volt. EIN is having a higher amplitude and EOUT is having a lower amplitude, but there is no phase shift. Both the waves have the same phase. In the case 3 is when the core is moving to the downward direction. So in that case, the EMF voltage induced in the secondary coil C is greater than when compared to the EMF induced in the secondary coil B. Therefore, the net output will be EMF in secondary coil B minus EMF in secondary coil C. That is a negative value, since EMF in secondary coil C is higher than that of EMF in secondary coil B. So again, example, at the EMF on secondary coil B is 2 volt and EMF or voltage on the secondary coil C is 3 volt, then the net EMF is 2 minus 3 volt, or 2 volt minus 3 volt, that is negative 1 volt. What does it mean? That is, negative means there is a phase shift, or the direction of the sinusoidal waves has shifted by 180 degree. So that is shown here. So you can see E in is, or EMF in is shown here, and EMF out is shown on the upper side. So there is a phase shift of 180 between input EMF and output EMF. So that is 180 degree phase shift happened when the core has moved to the downside. So if there is a 180 degree phase shift, we can see that the displacement is happening to the downward side. So one more thing we have to notice here is that this entire assembly of the LVDT is contained in a steel casing in order to prevent any losses, or in order to have an accurate reading, this entire LVDT setting is enclosed in a steel casing. That is, we can see the LVDT is placed inside a stainless steel housing because it will provide electrostatic and electromagnetic shielding. That is very important. There is some electromagnetic or electrostatic effect that will give us wrong reading. So in order to prevent that, the entire assembly is placed inside a stainless steel housing. So that is how the working of this LVDT. So we have three cases. So corresponding to three cases, we have different outputs. So the LVDT can be used to measure the displacement. This happened to some reference point. So this is a now another thing, or is output versus core displacement characteristics of an LVDT transducer. So a linear curve shows that output voltage varies linearly with the displacement of the core. So the y-axis shows the voltage and x-axis shows the core displacement on the positive direction and on the negative direction. So in both the directions, we can see as the core displaces, the voltage increases in a linear way on both positive and negative side. The x-axis shows the negative and positive displacement of the iron. The positive x means the core is in the positive displacement or it is moving to the upper side. Negative x means the core is in the negative displacement or it is moving to the downside. The curve indicates the core is taken out of the bobbin. Then coming to the advantages of LVDT. So we have one of first advantage is high range. So that is it has a high range of measurement is possible. We can use this instrument for measuring displacement ranging from 1.2 mm to 250 mm. There is no frictional losses. As the core moves inside the hollow former or it is moving in an air gap of the hollow former, so there is no loss of displacement input as friction losses, so it makes LVDT very accurate device. Then high input and high sensitivity. The output of the LVDT is so high that it doesn't need any amplification. So that's another important. We need not want to amplify or do any amplification to the output we obtain from the LVDT. The transducer possesses a very high sensitivity, which is typically about 40 volt per mm. Then hysteresis losses are very low. That is another advantage. Then we have low power consumption. Our power is only about 1 volt, which is very less compared to other type of transducers. Then direct conversion to electrical signals. They convert linear displacement to electrical voltage are easy to process. There is no intermediate stage. Displacement are directly converted to electrical signals. The disadvantages are LVDT is sensitive to magnetic fields. That is one of the disadvantages. If the external magnetic field or electrostatic force act on this linear variable differential transducer, that may interact with the flux and may cause wrong readings. So in order to prevent that, we are keeping this LVDT in a steel casing. So they are always required a setup to protect them from stray magnetic fields. They are affected by vibrations and temperature. It is concluded that they are very advantageous as compared than any type of other inductive transducers. In applications, so it is used in wide range of applications. They are used in applications where displacement ranging from fraction of mm to few centimeter can be measured. This very small displacement can be measured by the help of LVDT very accurately. The LVDT acting as a primary transducer converts the displacement electrical signal directly. So there is no intermediate conversion. Directly the displacement is converted to electrical signals. In some cases they can also act as secondary transducers. So that is again consider the example of a boron tube. Boron tube acts as a primary transducer. So what happens inside the boron tube is it will detect the pressure and convert into linear displacement of the boron tube. Then that linear displacement of the boron tube is converted to electrical signals by LVDT. So in this case it is acting as a secondary transducer. So primarily the boron tube converts pressure into displacement, and secondarily the LVDT converts displacement to electrical signals. So this is another application. Then it is used in all measurements. It is used to measure force, weight and pressure. Then measurement and control of thickness of metal sheet. Measurement of tension in a cord. So these are all applications of this LVDT. That is about the working of linear variable differential transformer. Hope you are clear with the working construction and features of LVDT. So, thank you for watching.